Hello viewers, welcome to you all in this third lecture on transformer. I am Dr. Vijay Sharma, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, Government Mahila Engineering College, Ajmer. In this video lecture, we will study about the ideal transformer. In previous lecture on the series, we have discussed about the transformer, its construction, working, core type transformer, shell type transformer, and we have also derived the EMF equation. Following are the contents for this video lecture. In this video lecture, we will discuss the characteristics of ideal transformer, including its the theory and the phasor diagram of the ideal transformer. We will also show or prove that KVA input of an ideal transformer is equal to the KVA of output, and as well as we will also solve a problem to understand the derivation. So let us start. An ideal transformer is not a practical transformer, and it is considered as an imaginary transformer because in such a type of transformer, output power is equal to the input power. Okay, and in this case, the efficiency of the transformer will be 100%, because whatsoever we have get at input, we are getting at the output. It means there is no power loss inside the transformer. However, this is not possible. So these transformer are not the practical. Okay, these are considered to be imaginary and ideal transformer. The characteristic features of the ideal transformer are as follows. Here we see that the power delivered by the transformer is equal to the power supplied to the transformer. That is why its efficiency is 100%. So efficiency will be 100% only whenever there is no not any loss is found any inside the transformer in the winding. So there will be no winding resistance, no reactance, which eliminates the copper losses inside a transformer. There should be no core loss, so there is no core loss, and there is no hysteresis loss or eddy current loss. So we have to eliminate all type of losses that can those can occur in the transformer, even though the entire magnetic flux should be linked from coil 1 to coil 2, and there should be no leakage flux. Okay, so these all are the features which we required with an ideal transformer. It is not possible with a practical transformer. So it is not impossible due to this reason. It is not possible to realize an actual transformer that having efficiency somewhere near to an ideal transformer, because efficiency will always be less than 100%. Because there will always be losses exist with a transformer. So the theory of an ideal transformer can be described by using this ideal iron core transformer. And in this figure, you will see that there are two coils, primary and the secondary. It is primary because it is connected with the source of sinusoidal source of supply V1. It is V2, which is connected with the load. So it will be the secondary side. It should be pointed out or focused here that woundings are in same direction. Okay, you will see with these lines, these are the woundings and these are in the same direction. And the number of turns in the primary and secondary is T1 or T2, it may be N1 and N2. And phi m is the linked flux generated, and it linked both the windings. Okay, so this flux passes through this low reluctance path and it gives us the linkage flux. Now we will see what is the phasor diagram, and since we have the ideal transformer and it has zero primary and zero secondary impedance, because there will be no loss, there will be no reluctance path, there will be no reactance with the coils. So in that case, the voltage induced in the primary E1 is equal to the applied voltage V1. So you can see here, whatsoever the voltage we have to apply here, it equals to E1. Similarly for coil 2, that is for secondary side, E2 will be equals to V2. Now current I1 is drawn from the supply, which is sufficient enough to produce mutual flux phi m, and this current I1 also produce the required magnetometric force. Okay, I1 T1, which is also known as magnetizing MMF. I1 T1. Okay, and this magnetizing magnetometric force overcome the demagnetizing effect of the secondary MMF I2 T2 as a result of connected load. Okay, so if you can see here, they give magnetizing effect, and they overcome the demagnetizing effect I2 P2. Now let us take that phi m is the reference phasor, which is given by phi equals to phi m sin omega t, as we have seen at the time of derivation of EMF equation. And EMF E1 and E2 is induced by the flux phi m are given by these two values. We have already derived these equation in our previous video lecture. So E1 will be E1 m sin omega t minus pi by 2, and here it will be for E2 it will be E2 m sin omega t minus pi by 2. E1 m and E2 m are the maximum value of induced EMF, okay, for E1 and E2 respectively. Now from these two equation we can see that primary induced EMF E1 and secondary induced EMF E2 lags phi m by 90 degree. So you will see in this phasor diagram that it is the referent direction for phi m, and E1 and E2 both are lagging with 90 degree to this phi m. You can see with this equation that omega t minus phi by 2, where the phi is sin omega t, but here it is minus pi by 2. So in order to be shown in the terms of phasor, we will see that direction of E1 and E2 is the lagging with the pi by 2 angle in reference to the phi m. Now by the Lane's law, E1 is equal and opposite to V1. So we will write the direction of this V1 and will be opposite to this E1. So this is the direction E1, and V1 will be opposite to this due to the Lane's law, because that according to Lane, the direction of induced EMF is always opposite. So the opposite, since E1 and E2 both are induced by same mutual flux phi m, hence E1 and E2 both are in same direction. So you will see that this E1 and E2, because these both are the induced EMF, and the direction will be the same. As there is no loss in ideal transformer, therefore total primary current I1 is used to magnetize the iron core without any loss due to resistance, stresses and eddy current. So I1 is equal to the magnetizing current I mu, which lags V1 by 90 degree. So you will see that this I1 is in the direction of phi m, and it is equals to I mu, and this I mu is termed as magnetizing current. Okay, and it lags by 90 degree to V1. You can see the V1 is plus 90, and this is zero reference, and this is plus 90, it is minus 90. So the produced mutual flux phi m is in phase with I mu. So the magnetizing current is in the direction of mutual flux phi m. And V2 is equal in magnitude to E2. So V2 will be equals to in magnitude E2, and it opposite to V1. So this will be the directions of V1, V2, E1, E2, I1, I mu and phi m. Now if we are interested to calculate the turn ratio for the same, what we will found that for an ideal transformer, if A is the transformation ratio or the turn ratio, then in that case this A can be written as the ratio of T1 over T2, either N1 and N2, both are the same. T is the turn and N is also the number of turns in the coil. So T1 over T2 equals to E1 over E2 equals to V1 over V2 equals to I2 over I1. Please be noted that for all the values N, E and V, it is 1 over 2, 1 over 2, 1 over 2, whereas for current it is inversely proportional. So by using this relation, what we can write that E1 T1 cross multiplying these two, I1 T1 equals to I2 T2, even we can write I1 N1 equals to I2 N2, what you have studied in your earlier video lecture, accordingly you can decide this. It is changes as per the books or the references. So don't get forget that this is the number of terms. Okay. So in equation 5, what it states that demagnetizing ampere turns of the secondary. So these are the demagnetizing ampere turns of the secondary, and these are equal to equal and opposite. So these are equal and opposite to the magnetizing MMF of the primary of an ideal transformer. So this first term, I1 T1, what it is? It is the magnetizing MMF. Okay, MMF, that means magnetomotive force of the primary of an ideal transformer, whereas this I2 T2 is the demagnetizing ampere turns of the secondary. So both these values are equal. Then using this and using the relation again, what we can write that E1 I1 equals to E2 I2. So this is equals to power, because E and V are the same. So the power is P equals to VI. So we can write V1 I1, that is the power on the primary, and V2 I2 is the power on the secondary, will be same. Now equation. So it can be found out that the volt ampere, that is apparent power drawn from the primary supply, okay, is equal to the volt ampere apparent power transferred to the secondary without any loss. So this is the case of an ideal transformer. So in this ideal transformer, input volt ampere, that is V1 I1, is equal to the output volt ampere V2 I2. So we can write V1 I1 equals to V2 I2. On dividing by 1000, on making cross multiplication, we have with us V1 I1 1000, V2 I2 1000, that is KVA1 equals to KVA2. That means the input kilovolt ampere is equals to output kilovolt amperes. So from this discussion, what we can conclude? We can conclude that KVA output, okay, so this is the KVA output, and this KVA output is same as the KVA input, okay, and KVA is same on both sides of the transformer, okay. Please be focused that here, importantly, here the primary and secondary currents are inversely proportional to their respective terms. Okay, in every case, in case of EMF, they are directly proportional to the number of turns, but in case of this is inversely proportional to current, because as the number of turns increases, that means the length of wire increases and it creates more resistance and the current will decrease. To understand this, we have to consider a problem here. And this problem, what is given in here is, it is desired to have a 4.13 milliweber maximum core flux in a transfer which is operating at 110 volt and 50 hertz. So determine the required number of turns in the primary. As we know, that in EMF induced in primary E1 is 110 volt and the supply frequency which is given to us is 50 hertz, and the maximum core flux given according to the problem is 4.13 milliweber, and that can be written as 4.13 into 10 to the power minus 3 weber. From the EMF equation, we know that the required number of turns on primary can be written as E1 over N1 is equal to 4.4 F phi maximum. Using that EMF equation, we can write that the number of turns on primary is N1 and it is equal to E1 divided by 4.44 F phi m. We have all three values with us. E1 is 110, F is 50 hertz, and phi is of this 4.13 into 10 to the power minus 3 weber. Putting all these value and calculating, we have with us the number of primary turns equivalent to 120. I am giving you a problem to solve and check out what you have understood with this lecture. These are the references. Thank you for watching this video. For any query, you can write me on this email address, that vijaysharma@gwaca.ac.in. For previous lecture, you can watch the following two links. Thank you for watching this video. Well, thank you.